You can pray standing, sitting, or any other way, but you can also bring more meaning to the prayer by the way you pray. Hey, I'm Dylan, and you're listening to Unlocked, your daily key to unlocking God's Word in your life. Something I used to do when I prayed before going to sleep was to actually get out of bed and kneel on the floor. It sounds very spiritual, but really, the reason was so that I wouldn't fall asleep in the middle of praying and I'd actually be awake the whole time. Now that I think about it, this is probably a good idea that I need to start doing again. But throughout the past, Christians have used certain poses in prayer for real meaning. And we'll hear about that from Taylor Ising's story, A Humble Posture. I was reading about different ways Christians have prayed throughout history, and I came across something that struck me. Christians in the early church used several different poses to pray, and each pose was connected to a different type of prayer. Lying face down on the ground was often connected with repentance, the standing was associated with praise, etc. But one pose caught my attention. Sometimes early Christians would pray standing with their arms stretched to the sides and their heads turned up toward the sky. And while poses like these have been used in different traditions and religions throughout history, early Christians connected this last pose to Jesus' body on the cross. And Jesus wasn't the only one who was crucified. During the time period when Christians in the Roman Empire were praying like this, they themselves were in danger of being crucified. Reflecting on this, an early church leader named Tertullian said, "Let crosses hang us, fires light us, swords cut our throats, beasts attack. The actual stance of the praying Christian is ready for any kind of punishment." These Christians knew what it was like to live a life of self-sacrifice. They knew they were in danger. They knew they were vulnerable. But they could face that vulnerability because they followed a vulnerable Savior. Jesus laid down his own life for us because he loves us. He let himself be killed, willingly assuming the same pose his followers would later use for prayer, a pose some of them would be killed in. Then he rose from the dead, making the way for all his followers, including those who were killed by Rome, to be raised when he returns. I'm blown away by the humility and vulnerability demonstrated in this form of prayer. It's a pose of peace and nonviolence, one that accepts pain instead of returning it. It communicates total praise and total self-sacrifice. It's the pose of Jesus. And I pray that, through the power of the Holy Spirit, he will help me embody this praise and self-sacrifice. Okay, let's talk about this for a second. Have you ever prayed in different poses? Standing, kneeling, laying down, hands folded, palms open, arms out, head up, head down, whatever? How could using different poses help us focus on different types of prayer? How has Jesus' self-sacrifice on the cross made it possible for us to live self-sacrificially? Now, as you and I can read in Philippians 2:8, "And being found in appearance as a man, Jesus humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross." And I'd encourage you to dig a little bit deeper. Read Matthew 5:38 through 42, Mark 15:33 through 37, and Philippians 2:1 through 11 to keep God's word alive in your life. Unlocked is a resource from Keys for Kids Ministries, and one way you can support Unlocked is by buying merch. You get something in the mail. At the same time, you're helping other teenagers develop a closer relationship with God. Just tap the store icon at the bottom of the Unlocked app or go to shop.keysforkids.org and tap merchandise. And come back for tomorrow's devotional with Natalie, how Jesus used just two verbs to build his ministry here on earth. But until then, I'm Dylan, encouraging you to live life unlocked, opening the door to God in your life.